Hey there YouTube, it's me too for wildness. Welcome to my channel and welcome to the third and final unboxing video of this month, the month of June of 2024. Right, got a little package here from Aliexpress, which as you can see has taken a bit of a biff in transit. Hopefully it'll be intact inside. It's a third party Legends figure from a well-known sort of like third party Legends company. It's a figure that I've had on the back burner for quite a while. It's a representation of one of my favourite characters, and I've been meaning to get around to getting this figure, but I haven't got around to it, and then this month I decided I'll pull the trigger on it. I looked around various prices on different websites, and AliExpress seemed to be the best option. It's just that I wasn't sure whether the AliExpress sellers were shipping it boxed or whether they were going to ship it loose. They should ship it boxed because being a third-party Legends figure, the packaging's quite small. Hopefully, this one is, but you can hear something's rattling around inside. So, yeah. So let's get on with it, shall we? I hate it when they wrap packages in this crap. You know, it's like polystyrene blocks wrapped in parcel tape. It's a very safe, secure way to ship something, but it's an absolute pain to unwrap at the other end. But anyway, let's get started. Right, I think I can see a seam line here. Right. Okay. Come on. Stupid bloody wrapping these. Right, what's in the package, Wilderness? Let's get it out. New Age Octavian. So, yeah, I've been meaning to get this. I'm an Ultra Magnus fan because obviously one of my detailed cells is full of them. Yeah, Legends Ultra Magnus. I've got a couple. I've got the original Magic Square one. I've got an oversized KO of the original Iron Factory G1 Ultra Magnus. I've also got the Papa Toys one, and I've got that that second Iron Factory, City to Command the Final Battle. I've got him as well. But yeah, but as for sort of like G1, Legends masterpiece-esque figures, I have got a couple of options, but I really wanted this guy because out of the Magic Square one and this was obviously the better of the two figures. So finally got him. So yeah, Ultra Magnus in his packaging, New Age. Got it off an AliExpress seller for about, what was it I paid for it? It was all right. It was a decent price I got it from. I mean, New Age's prices are getting quite silly now. They're pushing their prices up. They're becoming like the fans' toys of the third party, Legends scale market, aren't they? I mean, they don't restrict supply. Yeah, they do make enough to go around for everybody, but they are bumping their prices up because they know that the quality of their stuff is, they're fan favourites, and the quality of the stuff is really good, and they're getting a bit conceited. But also the price of plastic's going up because of cost of oil's going up and all that stuff. So yeah, but I do think that New Age are starting to take the piss with their pricing policies, especially like look at their New Age Michael, their Omega Supreme. Look at the prices that goes for. And I just noticed there's been a KO version of that that's come out for like less than half the price. It's like, yeah, maybe I might do the KO option instead of getting a proper one. But anyway, I wanted this guy, G1 Ultra Magnus. Because it's a bit loose in there, but hopefully it'll be all right. Wanted to get him, finally got him, and that was my package for today. I have got polystyrene chips everywhere, because of opening a polystyrene package. That's why I hate these things, because they're such a mess. It did survive the impact damage though, because you can see inside it hasn't dented it much. It took the there's a little bit of a bow in the box, I suppose. But anyway, that's it. That's my final unboxing for this month. The package is empty. I've been Tiff from Wilderness, and I'll catch you all next time. Ta-da.